Hi, this is Kate from MinuteEarth. And my dog Watson looks like this. But there are also dogs that look like this, and this, and this, and this, and this. They're so different that they barely seem like the same species. And while there are some definite weirdos in the feline world, cats generally look and act much more similar to each other than dogs. So yeah, doggos are way more diverse than cattos. Except they also aren't. Because under all those superficial differences, what scientists call phenotypic diversity, domestic dogs are surprisingly undiverse in the DNA department. On average, only a tiny fraction of dogs' DNA differs from each other. That's about as much as their owners, and several times less than cats generally differ genetically from each other. So why do dogs look and act so doggone distinctive compared to humans or cats? Well, because it matters how genetic differences are distributed within a species. Instead of genetic differences, let's look at colored dots. Say you have a bunch of dots, equal numbers of four different colors. Now, divide those dots up into four groups. Within each group, you could have all the colors represented. Each of these smaller groups, then, would include all the diversity that exists among the dots as a whole. Alternatively, each group could consist of dots of just one color. In this scenario, all the individuals in each group are really similar to each other, but they're really different from individuals in the other groups. This is kind of like what we've done with dogs. Over centuries of careful breeding, we've partitioned different genes and variants of genes into different groups of dogs. As a result, dogs in different groups, which we call breeds, are genetically really similar to each other and really different from dogs of other breeds. That's how, even without a ton of genetic variation, we've ended up with dogs with such distinct characteristics. Think stubby legs in wiener dogs versus ridiculous stilts in greyhounds. Compared to dogs, cats have more genetic diversity overall. But since we haven't been breeding cats as long or as carefully, their categories are less well-defined. Each breed still contains a lot of the genetic diversity that exists in the species as a whole. So cats within a breed aren't all that genetically similar. And cats of different breeds are somewhat similar. And as for us humans? Well, people within any one population of humans don't have much more in common genetically than they do with people from other populations. On top of all this, for reasons we don't exactly understand, a few spots in the dog genome have outsized effects on a dog's outside. As far as we can tell, variation in just 14 genes causes almost all the variation in dog size. Compare that to the several hundred genes that contribute to humans' height and BMI. So it's pretty straightforward to create dogs with a 40-fold size difference. But dogs aren't total outliers. We've bred chickens with a 15-fold size difference and turned a humble plant called Brassica oleracea into a diverse and delicious plethora of forms. So even though cats today all seem pretty similar, given another 100 years of careful selection, we could probably breed cats that vary as much as dogs. But first, we might want to consider whether breeding giant cats might be a giant catastrophe. Hey, you cool cats. We love it when you stick around to the end. You must like our stuff. If you want to support our work and your feline generous, you should join fellow MinuteEarth fans at patreon.com/MinuteEarth. Besides the warm fuzzies you'll get from supporting us, you'll also get to meet our team's warm fuzzies and cool scalies. We just shared photos of all the pets that make our work possible or impossible. And for just a few bucks per month, you'll also get early access to our videos, exclusive and behind-the-scenes content, plus regular chances to get free MinuteEarth merch. Our patrons are the reason we can keep making videos like these, and the reason we feel like the luckiest dogs in the world.